Right, so first of all, let me explain what it is that I've done with the neckline itself. Actually locate it. Right, this is the neckline, and I've used a similar method as the hem on this. This was the piece that was left over from the hem on the both sides. The hem trim was wider, and then I've prepared a narrower piece, and I've inserted the lace on as same manner as what I did with the hem, and then put those two on top of each other and actually just finished it off. Now this is a straight cut piece of fabric, so what you do is you just ajar it a little bit, and then I've prepared a sort of like a heart-shaped piece with the interfacing on, and I've attached this on the inside. I've just put it underneath, slightly widened it, stitched it all around the corners, and really just prepared the neckline. It's a very, very easy neckline to do. This neckline is also brilliant on sometimes where we have problems where we've gone and made the neckline too wide. Also, you can work with many variations of fabrics if you wanted to achieve a different result. You can use lace panels, which would work equally fine. You could work with fabric from the silhouette to attach as an insert. You know, there is absolutely abundance of stuff that you can do with this type of neckline. To attach the neckline, prepare your neckline prior to actually stitching onto the dress. Now, I have this dress is actually with a chemise, so it's going to have lining attached as well. So what we're going to do is, prior to actually attaching the neckline on, I would advise a simple straight seam going through the center to actually tie the two together. I mean, what you got to remember is sometimes I don't actually tie them in, and that's due to the fact that with so much experience in sewing, it's not a major problem for me. But if you are anything new to the sewing, then I would say lay the fabrics one on top of the other absolutely evenly. Evenly meaning that try and center it. If you've got fabric, slight bits of fabric left on either side, by all means leave it equal on both the sides, because lining is always better, bigger than the actual chemise, because you just trim away the excess. If you cut the lining too small, and if you try and fit your dress to the lining, then you will encounter problems. So always work with the lining larger than the actual dress. Lay out and trim the excess of the lining away. Once you've done the neckline, once you've attached all your pieces and you've straightened it and ironed it out. Okay, here what we're going to do is we have a slight bit of a problem with the chemise, where on the one side we've got the patterning on the shoulder, and the other side we've actually taken it out. So what we want to do is stay sort of focused and half and half. So what I've done is pushed that side slightly out so that I get an even width. Now here, as I was mentioning earlier, what you can do is before you go on to attaching the neck, because you're going to have to fold this over, I would say center seam this. And once you've laid it out and you need to take it back to the machine for center stitching, prior to that just stick a couple of pins so that those two fabrics, it doesn't matter about the arms and so on, because what you're trying to do is actually keep the fabric in the center. So pin this in a few places. And we've already center creased this, so on the center crease line what we're going to do is just a straight seam just to keep the fabrics. Later on that seam will get cut away and we won't actually be needing it, but we need it for the initially so that our fabrics remain central and tied together.